Afternoon, right? So lesson five, this is what we call, some parts of these are actually adjectives, okay? Right, so we have here adjective. Okay, I will use my annotation notes, okay? Adjectives, all right? So let's read this. Kamesh. Kamesh. Okay, so okay. That's the default for the adjective, okay? Can you read this? Try to read it. I hope you can read it for me. Put my participants here so that I can see all of you.
Tob Baslar.
Tov, very good. Okay. So when I say very good, the Hebrew word for that is rabah, rav, tov. Okay. Okay. Rav tov or tov rav, which means very good. Okay. If you want to say very good to a girl, you say rava tova. Okay. Rava tova. If I will say very good to all of you, I will say Rabim Tovim. Rabim Tovim. So that's the plural form for the masculine. Yes. Right. Good. Okay. So we have some words here that we need to memorize, probably. If you can memorize it. So you have here the masculine and then you have the feminine. Okay, this is singular. Then we have a masculine and then feminine also here. And this is the plural. So we have our first word is tov. Okay? So you have the word tov. Okay, so take note that this is adjectives. Okay? So you will notice that in Hebrew, the adjectives will have endings, okay? For example, for the feminine, you have kamitse ending. For the plural masculine, you have kirakyod mem ending. For the feminine, you have kolem wautau ending. So that is your ending for the adjectives. All right, so let's move on. Tov. Tova, tovim, tovoth. So the meaning is good. In English, you don't translate it as masculine tov or masculine good. You don't say that. Feminine good, you don't say that, but you just say good, right? So that's the first word. Then you have ra, okay? Ra, which means evil. And then ra'a, take note of the feminine ending, kamitse, the adds it. And then the ra'im, kirakyod mem ending, that's plural. Same meaning, basically. And then you have the kolem waw tau ending, ra'os. All right, so let's ask EJ. EJ is here, but I don't know if he can read it for us. Yeah. Esmeraldo, can you help us?
Pastor.
Yes, can you read this line here?
Which line is it? I will.
Yeah, the red one, okay? I want you to read it.
The great pastor?
The red one. Okay. That one.
God. This is the one. Pastor, can we come back to me later?
I will come back to you later.
Yeah, Pastor.
Okay. Aljay, I want you to read the next line. Open your mic. Or RJ, are you busy? RJ is busy.
Wala-wala akong internet, Pastor. Bago rin ang balik.
Okay, okay. All right, so RJ.
Yes, Pastor.
Can you read this line?
Wait, Pastor. Nag-problema po ko sa kong Pastor. Screen, Pastor.
Ah, okay. So you don't have a screen. Okay. Okay. So let me just read it for you first. Okay. So the first one here is Gadol, which means great. Okay. Yes. And then let me just clear all the drawings here. You have Gadol, great. And then you have Gedolah, feminine. And then you have Gedolim, the masculine. And then, okay. And then you have Gedolos, right? Then you have Katan, small. Then you have the feminine, Katana, the masculine plural, Ketanim. And then you have the feminine plural, ketanos, right? So that's how you're going to read that. And then you have the word wise. The Hebrew word is kakam. Okay, you can actually name your son kakam. And then you have also kakama for the feminine. If she's a lady, so you say kakama. And then if you have so many sons now, you would say, you would name them Kakamim, right? If you have so many daughters, you call them Kakamoth, right? Kakam, Kakama, Kakamoth, I don't know, Kakamim, Kakamoth. Okay, but I don't want you to name your children with this next word. The word is Kesil, Kesila, Kesilim, Kesiloth, which means foolish. So basically, if you read the book of Proverbs, you'll find out that these two words are very famous. You will always find these two words. I mean, frequently these two words appear in the book of Proverbs, Kakam and Kesil, all right? And then another one is also Yasar. Yasar is very famous in the book of Psalms, also in the book of Proverbs. Yashar means upright. The masculine is Yashar. For the feminine, you have Yashara. And then for the plural, you have Yasharim. And for the, okay, let me clear that. For the feminine plural, you have Yasharos. Yasharos, okay? And then you have the word Rasha, wicked. Rasha. And then you have Rashaim. And then Rashaos. So basically what you have here now is the pattern, or you call that as the paradigm for the adjectives. Are you with me? The word is?
Yes.
Para. Right, paradigm, or some would read that as paradigm. Okay, it doesn't matter whether it's paradigm or paradigm, but you know the meaning, it doesn't matter. Okay, because that can be understood whether paradigm or paradigm. All right, good. Okay, so right. Okay. Okay, someone is chatting. Probably this is very important. Wala-wala imong tingog. Okay, is my voice cutting off?
Sometimes, Pastor.
Did you putol-putol, Pastor?
Sometimes?
Sometimes, Pastor. Ha? Huh? For the rain, probably.
Choppy, Pastor. Sometimes choppy.
Choppy, okay.
Choppy. Okay.
Salamat.
Okay, how about this? Is it better?
Inay kayo, Pastor.
Inay gihapon?
Promadunggan na, Pastor.
Which is better, the other one or this one? Same.
I think the other one, Pastor, okay, more clear siya.
Okay, it's a little bit clearer. All right, so let's go.
Okay, good. All right, so okay, so also here we have ekad. This is number. Okay. So you have a number. Ekad. Okay. Yom Ekad. Have you heard about that? Genesis chapter 1. Genesis. Yom Ekad, which means day one. Okay. It's not actually one day, but you say day one. Ekad or Akath. Okay. And then you have, yes, this is the masculine. This is the feminine. This is masculine plural. I think this is, yes, this is feminine plural. Okay. Or yes. Right. So these are irregular forms basically of these words. Okay. So you have ish, men. Isha, woman. But when it comes to the masculine, it does not follow the pattern anymore. It should be ishim, right? Supposedly for ish. But the regular word becomes anashim, okay? The plural becomes anashim, which means men. And then for the woman, you have the word nashim. Right. For the brothers, you have ak, supposedly brother, that's feminine, but the word ak takes the feminine ending. So when it takes the feminine ending, kolemautau, instead of translating it as brother, you translate it as sister. Okay. For the plural, you have akim, and then you have Akayoth for the sisters. Okay. So I hope you have to take note. You have taken note of that because these are irregular words that appears in the Hebrew words. Okay. All right. So just a recap of what we have on top. Okay. Feminine singular ends with Kamed say, masculine plural usually ends with kirekyod mem. For the feminine plural, usually it ends with wow tau or kolem tau or kolem wow tau. Okay. So, kindly take note of that. All right. When number four, you have to take note also when masculine singular forms begin with kamed, feminine and plural have. Okay, shua and kamit satuf. Hatif patak. Okay, so you have hatif patak there. Okay, so we'll be taking a short break for a while and then please log in again. Okay, all right,
yes, sir, yes, sir.
Kindly log in. Yes, back. Sir. Thank you.